We've anointed 2023 as the year of the OLED. These are Samsung's new Galaxy Book laptops, one of the pioneers in the field. So how are they going to keep up with the competition? We'll show you. Hi, it's Mark Hockman from PC World, and we are at the launch of Samsung's new Galaxy lineup. Now, normally Samsung means thin, light, OLED, and ecosystem. But this time around, we have something new to show you, a slightly larger, slightly thicker, slightly more professional Galaxy Book Ultra. Now, normally, you would think this would have a latest Intel processor and an integrated graphics chip inside of it. But no, this time around, Samsung has put the 13th generation Intel Core i7 and an i9 within it, as well as the most recent NVIDIA GeForce RTX 4000 series GPUs as well. Again, this is designed more for content creation, as well as some light gameplay. And what we see are some features designed for that particular market. The key is this new 3K display. It has a slightly unusual resolution. It has a 2880 by 1800 display. It puts out 400 nits, and it has what's called an AMOLED 2X display powering it. The key here is that normally this would have slightly smaller color gamut, but here it's 120% of the DCI P3. What this translates to in real world is a much more vibrant, vivid display. One of the things that you'll see alongside of it is the new Thunderbolt 4 ports. These are pretty standard on most laptops these days, but again, they provide additional connectivity and extensions to various external I/O devices, including storage. There's also one thing that I want to mention here. This is an HDMI 2.0 port. The other laptops we're going to see today have an HDMI 1.2 port. The key here is that HDMI 2.0 is geared towards an external display, 4K video at 60 Hertz. That's more designed for content creation. The other laptops with the less powerful HDMI port are designed for 4K exporting or viewing 4K video at 24 Hertz. That's more of a content creation, a content consumption machine. So this particular device has both options for 8, 16, 32 gigabytes of LPDDR5, as well as 256, all the way up to 100 or to 1 terabyte of SSD storage. Because this is still a thin and light machine, you're not going to see a Windows Hello webcam. You are going to see a 1080p webcam, which is a slight upgrade from what other laptops give you. But you are going to see login capabilities in the fingerprint reader inside the power button up here in the corner. That's been pretty standard for Samsung laptops throughout their history. So what is all this going to cost you? It's going to run at $2,199 for the i7, $2,799 for the i9, shipping on February 24th. Now, these other laptops are a little bit more of the standard Samsung offerings. We have two versions of the Galaxy Book 3 Pro. That's these. We have a 14-inch and a 16-inch. And we have at the very end, which we'll talk about in a second, the Galaxy Book 360, a 360-degree convertible. Let's talk a little bit about the Pro models. These again actually have the upgraded display of the Ultra. In fact, if you're looking for a laptop with just a vibrant screen from top to bottom, Samsung's actually got you covered. Again, we're talking about 2880 by 1800, 120 hertz, 400 nits, and again, this upgraded DCI P3 color gamut. Again, the specs look pretty good, just again, top to bottom. 8 to 32 gigabytes of LPDDR5, 256 to 100 to 1 terabytes of SSD storage, and you again have the Thunderbolt 4 ports on the side, as well as the HDMI 1.2 port in this case. If we go to the other side, we see this as well on this machine, as well as the others, including the Ultra. You've got an SD card slot, a conventional Type-A USB slot for legacy devices like printers or keyboards or mice, and the headphone jack as well. You might recall that Samsung has eliminated the headphone jack in some of its phones, so it's nice to see it within the PC. Prices on those will be $12.99 for the 14-inch, and again, starting at $13.99 for the larger 16-inch, which is actually not as profound of a delta as I would expect. So again, if you're looking for something that's a little bit on the larger side, you may not have to pay it that much more. One thing that I will note on these 16-inch models that I personally kind of find attractive, look at the size of that touchpad. I mean, that thing is absolutely mammoth. You know, part of that, of course, is the fact that it has just a huge palm rest for you to be able to rest your palms upon. But my goodness, it's pretty much clickable up to the top. Just a little bit, not quite here at the top. You're also seeing a little bit of flex in the touchpad. You can see it kind of bounce a little bit. Something that you might trade off as far as weight's concerned, but stability-wise, it's still pretty solid. Again, you'll notice the smaller laptop does not have the separate 10-key keypad that the 16-inch model has. You'll notice those are still standard on the Ultra as well as the larger 360 model as well. Again, not something you'll necessarily need except for data entry, or if you happen to be a left-handed gamer who wants to go ahead and control the gameplay with your right hand. So that is the Pro series. Again, $12.99 and $13.99. Let's talk a little bit about the 360. Now, the 360 is unique with two different ways. First of all, it's a 16-inch device. It's only a 16-inch device. 2880 by 1800, again, 400 nits, 120 hertz, Core i5, Core i7 with the 13th gen. With these smaller laptops, with the 360 as well as the Pro, you're not gonna get the discrete GPU. It's only the Iris Xe within it. But you do have two things that the 360 offers that the others do not. One, of course, is the S Pen. The S Pen is not holstered within the laptop chassis anywhere. Samsung's kind of gone back and forth on that. But very nice for inking. We can go ahead and open up Samsung Notes, and we can actually go ahead and either write just like this, put it down, which is easier for me. Whoops, there we go. And again, it really feels quite comfortable to write on. You're not really feeling like there's a soft nib on this pen. So the inking experience is not what you would think of as inking on glass. It feels very papery as you're inking. And you'll notice that if we got on a straight edge, we'd hopefully see a straight line when we go diagonal. That's one of the keys when you're inking, is you don't want any of this ink jitter. But we're seeing, it looks pretty good. And we're seeing that the ink's flowing where the nib is, and that's what you want. You don't want any offset there. So from a creative process, that's exactly what you want. The other thing that we should notice, or we should note about this particular device, is that there is an optional 5G, specifically a 5G sub 6 option. You'll see some of that in rival laptops coming with ARM processors. This is just integrated right into the laptop. Again, if you're looking for an always-on connected device, the 360 is what you want. Finally, let's talk about the price on this. It's a single model, the i7, so there's a single price, and that is starting at $18.99. All these laptops will begin shipping very soon. The Pro and the 360 will begin shipping on February 17th, and the Galaxy Book 3 Ultra will ship a little bit later on February 24th. So that wraps up Samsung's Galaxy Book launch here in San Francisco. Keep it tuned to PC World's YouTube channel and to PCWorld.com for more great tech content.